This is the Strat-O-Matic Baseball Excel 1970-73 Carryover League. Brought to you by the Shrimp Trawler YouTube channel.
Welcome back, baseball fans, to the 1970-73 Carryover League. It's another opening day, and this would be the final opening day in the American League schedule between the Texas Rangers and Milwaukee Brewers. I guess I can take a quick peek. I haven't actually done this till now, so I'll do it live here and see what's the standings already. So in the American League, Midwest and the West were playing. And the West won all the best of fives. So we have a three-way tie, and a three-way tie there. And now the Brewers are going to try and beat the Rangers in a series to put them in first place. Now the Rangers lose that series, they'll be in last place. And vice versa, they'll be tied. And of course, in the top, well, we still have to play Toronto and Cleveland. Yeah. But it looks like the East is predictably taking care of the North. That's X-Rails. Okay. Way too early. Look at the standings, folks. Way too early. Today we have the Rangers and the Brewers. Really like the Rangers draft. I thought they have the good blend of old and new. They, of course, brought back Mike Epstein and Frank Howard, the monsters who helped them get to the playoffs a couple years ago. They imported Merv Rettman to that team, which was a nice haul. And then recently in this draft, they added Jeff Burrows and Toby Hara. So they are putting it together in Texas nicely. Maybe they rise up to compete with the A's, perhaps second or third place, or win the whole thing. And the Brewers, this is not a good era for them, but they added some nice pieces that we'll see today. Daryl Porter is actually going to be leading off because he has so many walks on his card. Good for them. And catching, making his major league debut. They traded for George Scott in the offseason. They have him. They traded for Ken McMullen. They drafted Jim Colburn to anchor their pitching staff. They traded for Mike Torres. So some interesting pieces. Milwaukee did get better. But, we just saw the standings. So it's not too far for the Brewers to actually get in the first place. All right, let's get started today. From Milwaukee, today's starting pitchers, Big Game Bob Johnson for Texas. I forget why we called him Big Game Bob Johnson. 2 years ago, he won some playoff games for Kansas City. Then he got traded. And then for Milwaukee, we got Jim Colburn making his debut here. It's not necessarily a rookie. It just means that his card has not been brought into the league until now in the year of 1973, where he's a 20-game winner in 300 innings. Let's get started from Milwaukee. Leading off, it is Merv Rettman. 49 for Merv is a walk. He is a B-stealer. Daryl Porter has a zero arm. Ed Stroud hit away. Ed Stroud, 66, pops to first. Jeff Burrows batting third. 2-3, ground ball to short, B. Fielder's choice. So with two out, that's Mike Epstein. 2-6, let's take a look at the Epstein card. We hit the card, folks. It's a two-column, 2-8, 2-6, homer, 1-8, double. And that is gone. Mike Epstein picking up where he left off. And the Rangers are up 2-0. Now the big guy, Frank Howard, debuting his 70 card. Let's take a look at it. Looks a lot like the 69 card. More disparity. He damages lefties a lot more than righties in this version. And the 69 card is more balanced. But in any event, it's ridiculous. 2-3. The grounder to short. Bottom of one. Leading off, Daryl Porter. 49, pops to third. JLU also acquired in the offseason. 1-7, ground ball to third. He was acquired in the three-team trade between the Red Sox, the A's, and the Brewers. The Red Sox ended up with Tommy Harper and Marty Patton. The A's ended up with Mike Hegan and I don't know who else. And the Brewers ended up with George Scott and Jesus Alou. J. John Briggs, 2-7 is a walk. On two outs, it's Jim Fregosi, 3-12, lines to the third. Fregosi was acquired last year from the Angels, who gave up on him pretty quickly after 69. All right, Satriano leading off in the second inning. 33, let's take a look at Tom Satriano's card. Doesn't have a long shelf life. This might be his last year. And at 33, though, homer 1-2, double, and that is a double. Dave Hef Nelson, 58, flies a left. Bernie Allen, 1-4. Let's take a look at Bernie's card. We had this card a few years ago. He was tearing it up, playing second base. He's had to move over to third base to make room for Dave Nelson to play second. 1-4 is homer 1-3, fly ball, and he just misses it and rolls the 4. Two outs, and it's Toby Hara, 34, grounds are short. Bottom of two, Don Mincher, 211, grounds a third. George Scott, 47 is a K. And Steve Hovely, 211 is a K. Top of the third, Merv Rettman, 35. That's going to be a single for the B-Stealer. Ed Stroud, 1-6, is a base hit because you had to hold Rettman at first. So you have runners at the corners, no one out. They'll have to hold, play it back for double play. Jeff Brose, 2-8, strikeout. Same thing for Mike Epstein. 1-5 is a center B question mark for Rettman. A 15 runner, 16-17. Minus 1 is 16 against Hovely. And he scores on the 1. 3-0, Texas. Frank Howard, 48. 1-15 off of Colburn is a single. And Satriano, 3-10. Another hit for him, a single to center field. Stroud can fly. He's a 15 runner, 16-17. Minus 1 is 1-16. Buddy's thrown out on an 18. Nice throw by Mr. Steve Hubley in his minus 1 arm. Guns down Ed Stroud at the plate. That could be a big play in this game. So they only score one run on the 4 singles. 3 zip. Ken McMullen, 56 is a K. McMullen was a Washington Senator, California Angel, Texas Ranger, eventually becomes a Dodger. Dick Schofield, 63. Pitcher X, Bob Johnson's an E0. Makes the play. And Darrell Porter, 49, pops the third. We got the fourth. It's Dave Full Nelson, 35. Flies left field. Bernie Allen, 56. Bounces to short. This is Fregosi's a 2E22. Makes the play. Toby Hara, 3-10. This guy's the center. Bottom of the fourth, we have Jesus Alou, 49, is a K. Johnny Briggs, 1-10, base hit to center field for E-Stealer. Fregosi, 2-9, is a base hit in the center. Well, Briggs trying to go coast to coast, down 3 runs. He's a 14 runner. Stroud's a 0 arm. I don't like to do that down 3 runs. Not the kind of luxury you want. First and second, one out, Don Mincher. 65, good. He didn't run. Now you got extra ducks in the pond for Mincher's blast. 6-5 off of the Bob Johnson card. Homer, 1-3. Double the rest, and he gets the double. One run scores for Gosi. He's a 13. Again, he'll hold up at third base. So now you got the tie runs in scoring position, but still just one out. They're going to play back with a two-run lead for George Scott. 46 is a K. And two outs, Steve Hovely. 58, skies to right field. 3-1 game into the fifth. It's Merv Rettman, 54, lines are short. Ed Stroud, 37's a K. And Jeff Burrows, 69, is a sky to center. Colburn's starting to settle down. Retired 6 in a row after the guy got thrown out the plate. Bottom of the fifth, Ken McMullen, 58, is a K. Schofield, 49, pops the third. And Darrell Porter, 1-8. Let's take a look at the Darrell Porter card. Nice little card of 1973. I'm not sure if it's his, I don't think it's his rookie card. but certainly a fun card to get into the league, at least in a platoon. You don't mind being in the game against lefties as he has power, but he's pretty much a one-way player here, in a good way it is. Homer, 1-4, double is a two-base hit. JLU with two outs, 47 is a K. 3-1, Texas after five. Let's pause a moment for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Top of the sixth inning. Colburn and Johnson are both starter eights. Here's Mike Epstein in the top of the sixth, 4-12. Rolls the pitcher. Frank Howard, 34, sky to the center. And Satriano, 3-10, is a base hit. Two outs, a man at first for Dave Major Nelson. 58, skies the left field. 3-1, bottom of the sixth. It's Johnny Briggs, 54, center X. Who's out there? Ed Stroud's a 3-3 in center, and he makes a catch. Jim Fregosi, 37's a walk. Your tie run is Dangerous Don Mincher. 69's a walk. Two on, one out. For George C. Scott. 1-9. George Scott is a 6-4-3. Double play. Ends the inning. We go to seventh. Still 3-1. Bernie Allen leads off. 1-5. Sky's right. Toby Hara, 37K. Merv Rettman. Merv Rettman, 4-10, pops to second base. Stretch time here in Milwaukee on opening day. They got hot dogs rolling around. They got pepperoni. They got sausage. They're doing all that crazy stuff out there. We're enjoying the tunes of Chet and Lester. Chester and Lester. That would be Chet Atkins and Les Paul. There you go. Les Paul, Wisconsin native. Had to be you out of nowhere. Birth of the Blues, Someday Sweetheart. 1976, almost in the timeline, but you get the idea, folks. Bottom of the seventh inning, we have Steve Hovley. 55, bounces a short. This is Toby Palindrome Hara, 338. Makes the play. Nice play, Toby. Ken McMullen, 35, flies left. And Schofield. 2-6 is a walk. Your tie run again is Daryl Porter. 1-7-1-8 would look awfully good right now for them. 45 is a sky to center field. 3-1 in the eighth. Breaking inning for both. Not looking at defense replacements quite yet. Ed Stroud leads it off. 2-10. Single 1-11. He gets a base hit. Now he is an ace stealer. Porter's got a zero arm. We haven't tried it yet. We got the lead. Let's try a stolen base. And he steals. Is in there. And what is the T rating for Mr. Daryl Porter, the rookie? It's T1 to 11. It's bad, but not bad enough. It says 20. So we get the stolen base. We have a runner at second. Nobody out. Burrows. 2-3. Ground ball to short. Mike Epstein, the big RBI guy of the game for the Rangers, driven all three. Runner at second with one out. 1-6 is hit by the pitch. All right, Colburn is about to break. We'll let him go. I mean, he's hustling here. He's doing his best, folks. And he's still competing for a win. He'll pitch to the big guy. You got to break him, get him out of there. It is his breaking batter. Frank Howard, first and second, one out. The pitch to Frank, 6-10. Center X. And this is Hovley out there again, a 3-7 in center field, and he makes the catch. The runners don't move. Two outs, and it's Tom Satriano, who is incredulously 3-for-3 today. That might be a first for the 236 hitting catcher from the Boston Red Sox. Boston had like six catchers one year. They had Moses and Satriano and Montgomery and Fisk, and it was ridiculous. But Satriano was picked up by the Rangers, and here we go. No bigger moment than now. The pitch to Tom Satriano. 2-9. He cannot collect hit number four. He lines the first base. Now in a 3-1 game, Satriano might leave for Dick Billings, better defensive catcher. Bring him in there. We also have Billy Conigliaro could play outfield for one of these guys for Burroughs. Let's get Epstein out of there. Put Burroughs at DH. I'll just get Burroughs out of there. It's fine. And we'll just put Conigliaro in left field. And that'll pretty much do it. Conigliaro in left. Billings is catching. Maddox doesn't help defensively. Six outs to go. 3-1 game. Big game, Bob Johnson. You got Paul Lindblad and Frank Lindsay and Denny Riddleberger warming. The Rangers have one of the rare five-man rotations, as Bob Johnson's the only guy who can pitch on 3 days rest. So they have a three-man bullpen with Bill Gogolewski. This is silly. Gogolewski and Riddleberger. My goodness. You get more humorous with your names. Bottom of the eighth. J.L. Lou leads it off. 4-11. First X. Who's over there? Oh, it's Big Frank. Frank Howard is a 3-22 at first. And he makes the play. Johnny Briggs, 1-7. Double 1-2 is a base hit. Your tie run is Fregosi. We haven't looked at the card, have we? I don't think we have. Let's take a look at Fregosi's card. Yeah, I mean, the last big year of this guy. A 278, 670 plate appearances for the Angels and 22 home runs in 1970. The Angels knew what was coming. The Brewers did not. They made the trade, and he will not produce like this in the future, unfortunately. But he can produce right now, and that would be wonderful. So here's the pitch to Fregosi. 57 is a K. And with two outs, it's Dangerous Don Mincher. Now, Dangerous Don. Oh, you're not even close to breaking Johnson. He'll pitch to him. 110 is single, 1-15. He lines out on a 20. 3-1 game in the ninth. We've had some great pitching in the recent round of openers. So we'll go to the ninth. And Jim Colburn, he's going to come out after eight as he's halfway to breaking. They're going to go with Earl Stevenson in the ninth, lefty. Coming in. And he'll face Dave Nelson Riley, leading off. Run out of Nelson Brittles. Sky to center field. Bernie Allen, 47 is a base hit. Now, Toby Herrick can hit lefties pretty nicely. Let's take a look at the Toby Herrick card. This is the 73 card. Now, we had a couple cracks at him. It wasn't very good. We had to wait till 73. Then you bring him up. And now you bring him up, he's 260. He'll get a lot better than this as well before he shipped off to Cleveland later in the decade. But he's ready to go now, particularly against lefties. Here's the pitch to Toby Herrera. 2-11, skies to right. And with two outs, it's Rutman. 1-6 against the lefty. Take a look at the Merv Rutman card. Yes, folks, another Baltimore Oriole player taken hostage and swept away from the Orioles. Because, again, the Orioles can't keep all their guys. It's a 32-team league. And the Rangers ended up with him. What a catch, man. What a great guy to get. He's got two more good years left, and then he has a nice on-base percentage the rest of his tenure in the major leagues. 1-6, though, that is gone. Two-run blast in the ninth inning off of Earl Stevenson, and we got a 5-1 game, and they're starting to drift towards the exits here in County Stadium. Easy Ed Stroud with two outs. Pops are short. All right, ninth inning. Bob Johnson will leave after eight. We're going to start the ninth inning off with Denny Riddleberger. Riddle me this, Denny. You were on the Senators in 71, but you got drafted by the Indians last year, and you were traded back to Texas in this year's draft. For who? The answer is Mike Kilkenny. That's your Denny Riddleberger riddle of the day. Bottom of the ninth. 5-1 lead. You got Scott, Hovley, McMullen, Schofield, and some pinch hitters, probably. Here's George Scott. 5-11 off Riddleberger. Pitcher X. He is an E0. This is going to be difficult. He He's the second E0 pitcher on the team behind Bob Johnson and Mike Paul and Broberg and Rilleberger and Lindsay and Lindblad. The entire Texas Ranger bullpen cannot commit an error. It's like having a bunch of Greg Maddoxes out there. My goodness. Texas. Buy stock, folks. I'm telling you now, this is a sleeper team. I know they were in last place a year ago, but there's always this yin and yang year to year. You suck one year, and the next year you draft well, get some good draft picks, and you come right back. And then the year after that, you go back into the tank. Steve Hovley, he'll hit away. 410, short X. Whoops. Shortstop X. This is Hara, a 3E38. And he makes the play. And with two outs, it's Ken McMullen. The pitch to Ken, 46 off of Rilleberger, is a double 1-4 base hit. Batting for Dick Schofield. Schofield, somebody better. Let's see, we got our choice between Reichert, Theobald, or McNurtney. They're all pretty good. Let's get some on base here. We're down by four. Let's go with let's take a look at Jerry McNurtney. He was the catcher last year. Fine full-time catcher, but they drafted Daryl Porter, which took half of McNurtney's at-bats away. But here, he needs to get back into the manager's favor. The pitch to Jerry McNurtney, 34, rolls to the pitcher, and that'll do it. From County Stadium, Milwaukee. Final score, the Texas Rangers 5, the Milwaukee Brewers 1. And we'll do the box. Stevenson in the ninth inning, 2 hits and 2 runs. That didn't help. Kind of ruined the, blew a hole in the Brewer parachute today. 8 hits and 3 runs off of Colburn. It happened in the first inning and the third inning, all from Mike Epstein. 2 walks and 3 strikeouts. Rilleberger doesn't get a save. It was a 4-run lead. Gives up a hit. I award saves for 3-run protection. I know that's not how it's generally done, but I do it that way. 5 hits and 8 innings for big game Bob Johnson with 1 earned run, 4 walks, 8 strikeouts. 1-09, 0-109, 0-109, 5-10, 1-6. 2-3-4-8. All right. 1-1, Texas, Milwaukee. Let's take a look here now at the year-to-date numbers, which are going down nicely, kind of realistically, if you want to call it, as far as good pitching and decent hitting, the era that we're moving into, away from 69. The 69 cards are gone, so the hideous offensive stats in that expansion year are gone. So we're starting to see some quality pitching, making the games more low scoring and more back and forth and competitive. You saw best of fives between these two divisions. And we've got 54 games in the books. Look at that, 258 batting average and a sparkling 351 ERA. I don't think I've ever had an ERA below 350 outside of opening day, perhaps. This far into a season, and we're drifting below that. That would be remarkable to get the league ERA below 350 with a DH in both leagues and picking out hitters' best year out of four. So that's it today from Milwaukee. We'll have the results at the end of this video, the results of the series. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks, Chet and Les. We'll see you next time. Well, baseball fans, we got some bonus baseball for you. Have a thrilling series. After the Rangers won Game 1 pretty convincingly, in Game Number 2, Bill Parsons for the Brewers against Mike Paul for the Rangers. And the story was Bill Parsons, 3 hits through 8 innings, gave up a run in the third inning. And in the middle innings, they got to Mike Paul, and they also got to Frank Lindsay in the bullpen. Brewers get their first win of the year in Day 2. 4-1 is the final. The team split in County Stadium. We go to Arlington for Game Number 3, and the Rangers with Pete Broberg pitching 6 2/3, did a nice job. Frank Lindsay gets a save in this game, a 5-2 victory. Jerry Royce got knocked around in the middle of this thing. Another home run for Rettman, And a home run for Johnny Briggs. 5-2, Rangers up 2-1. They want to finish this in Arlington. So what happens in game number four? Well, game four, it is Bill Hans. He used to be their ace, but he slid down to the four spot in the rotation against Mike Torres, acquired in an offseason deal. In the fourth inning, a three-run homer by Epstein and four runs, and the Rangers are thinking we got this, 4-0. We have a solo homer here by Steve Hovley on a homer 1-2 chance. We have a homer by Fregosi there. It is a 4-2 game in the ninth. Paul Lindblad, one of the best closers in baseball, wants to come in and finish it off. The Brewers have other ideas. They have 5 hits and 4 runs in the ninth off of Paul Lindblad to even the series. 2 games apiece. Home and road wins for both squads, which brings us back to Milwaukee and Les Paul for game 5. Same stars in game 1. Big game Bob Johnson and Jim Colburn, the game you just saw. Well, here we are, folks. Early on, a 2-run double by Burroughs, a 3-run homer by Epstein, and it's 5-0. Or 5-2 after 5. Then in the bottom of the 8th, a 2-run homer by Johnny Briggs, and that's where we're at, folks. It is 5-4. The Brewers again trying to come back. But we go into the 9th inning. Live baseball. Jim Colburn just came out, and here comes Ken Sanders in as the best pitcher in a game 5, trying to make sure they don't score any more runs. Take a look at the Sanders card, perennial all-star. Merv Rettman leads off in the 9th for Texas. 5-10 is a walk. Normally you don't steal in front of Frank Howard. Frank Howard, 48, is a K. All right, now you can steal. Rettman's going to try a stolen base. He's dead meat. I should say you don't try and steal in front of Mike Epstein either. But he was pulled. Epstein's up. What am I talking about? With 2 outs, Mike Epstein. 63 off Sanders. Rolls it to second base. Schofield's a 3-E-28, and he makes the play. So, bottom of the 9th. And again, it is Paul Lindblad. Does he blow back-to-back games? It's a 5-4 game. Lindblad's out there. Let's take a look at his card. Magnificent closer. And this card would be a Washington Senators card in 1971. And the big story, like we say, is don't let your Senators become Athletics. Yeah, Lindblad, Epstein both went to Oakland from the Senators, and, well, they won some World Series. But Texas is going to hold on to these guys. Well, after the game 4 bombing, maybe not. So here we go in the bottom of the 9th, a 5-4 game. Ken Lindblad get the save. Leading off is Ken McMullen. 58 is a pop to short. Batting for Dick Schofield. It'll be Ron. You know, Ron Tebow doesn't have any power. Let's go for a game-tying homer at least. Jerry McNurtney. Let's take a look at Jerry. Jerry McNurtney here. The pitch to Jerry. 45 off Lindblad is a pop to short. And with 2 outs, it's all up to Daryl Porter. And I don't like my chances there. He doesn't hit lefties very well at all. So batting for Daryl Porter. The other power hitter on the bench, Rick Reichert. Let's take a look at Rick. Very similar to McNurtney card you just saw. 2-10 ties this thing. 2 outs, bottom of the 9th of game 5 of a 5-4 game. Paul Lindblad trying to get a save. The pitch to Rick Reichert. 34 is a roller to third. Twice is the charm. Didn't work the first time. Worked the second time. Nice 2-inning save for Paul Lindblad. And the Rangers win the series 3-2. The American League West beat the American League Midwest 3-2 in 4 consecutive series. That's interesting. Sanders a walk and a K in the 9th. Jim Colburn, another tough loss. 7 hits and 5 runs. We had 6 walks and a strikeout. Lindblad came in the 8th, gave up a hit. That was it. Much better than game 4. Big game Bob Johnson ran out of gas in the 8th inning, gave up 8 hits and 4 runs. They were all earned. Walked one, struck out seven. 1009, 0109, 5749. 7217. Let's take a look at the cumulative box for the two squads now. What a long opening week of baseball, folks. All these best of five series are being stretched out to five games. That means this league is tight, competitive. Exciting finishes, fantastic finishes. So the Brewers, a little disappointed after that magnificent comeback in game four. 2-3 are the Brewers, hitting .283 with a .409 ERA. Colburn lost both his starts. Offensively, we got seven hits for J.L. Lou batting second. That's a nice acquisition. The Rangers. Texas tied for first with everybody out west, hitting .250, .327 ERA. And Bob Johnson's won both of his starts. Mike Epstein's only 4 for 16, but he's got 3 homer and 9 RBI in 5 games. Big home runs for Mike Epstein. And the league now, after playing more baseball, 58 games, hitting .259, .353 ERA. I think you saw a number similar to that earlier. Thanks for checking out the magnificent finish between the Rangers and the Brewers. We'll see you next time.